electricity down there in Lancaster, California. But you know, anybody know who Bob Hoover was, right?
Yeah.
And what's that guy that broke the sound barrier?
John Yeager,
right? Where did they operate when they were in their heyday?
Edwards.
No, Muroc. Before it was Edwards. Called Muroc. And there was a little cafe down there, bar, and a lady called Pancho Barnes. Pancho Barnes had a brother, Bill, and he
was her son.
Had a son, Bill, and he was a flight instructor, correct?
He owned Barnes Aviation.
Barnes Aviation, and he taught this guy private pilot training way back in
1967.
When?
67.
So he aviation royalty right here. See that bloodline? Chuck Yeager, Bob Hoover, Pancho Barnes, Bill Barnes, Raymond Dean. 50 years of aviation. You didn't get caught at anything, right? By the FAA at anything. No citations?
No.
No jail time? So I think that's a marvelous achievement. And the FAA had instituted the Master Pilot Award 7-8 years ago, I think it was. And as time goes on, more and more people are getting them. But his name now goes on the National FAA Registry Database as a Master Pilot. So as long as the FAA has a computer system that operates, you'll be known throughout the world. Anybody that looks at that list. Jack Kilpatrick, you're on it. Who else is on it in the building today? Herb is on it. Well, you guys are buds now for life.
They ride bikes?
No. He still rides a Harley at 80. How old are you now? Go ahead and say it.
I'm 103, but
I'm 79. You still ride his big red Harley?
Not so much anymore.
Right. So I think it's fantastic. So anyway, the FAA has given a certificate to you, and there's a lapel pin. All your friends did those letters that you sent out.
Talked to one guy.
I got two letters from down south, and I wrote one. I lied through my teeth, but I wrote one. So he gets this nice certificate, which is a real nice walnut frame. It looks good.
Ben and Jerry.
Ben and Jerry? Oh, Ben and Jerry on the cover here. So, here.
Very nice.
Hold that right there.
All right.
There you go. And the other thing that's real nice, Raymond, is next week they're going to FedEx all your pilot records. I think they're coming to me. Everything they have on you at Oklahoma City, they don't know about it. So I tell you, you never get caught, right? I kind of did that at David's one time.
I just had to pay for it.
So, I mean, just think, if you're young enough, you too can get this one day. Just keep your nose clean. And it's quite an honor. I just imagine what people have in his lifetime as an aviator, what he's seen. My dad died at 87, and he was born in 1922. And we were talking one day, and he's telling me about all the things that he's seen in his lifetime. And it was just amazing. And that was in the 80s. And just think, you were born when?
1938.
So in the height of the Depression, you were born.
That's so embarrassing.
Why? We all got a number.
Okay.
I mean, I'm only 52, but I got a long way to go.
You look like you're older than
So anyway, there's a lapel. You can see it right there. There's a lapel pin there, and there may be another one in there. They used to get one for the spouse, but I can't tell. And then the records will show up next week, and you'll be on the national record.
Well,
so,
how about that?
Well, congratulations. All right.
I mean, the first round school lesson.
Is that right? Yeah, I didn't know that, Chuck Yeager.
May I be the first to welcome you to the area of the octogenarian pilot?
That's fine.
I just announced this morning we're having a meeting in October, 4th, the first Wednesday in October.